in the days when Duke Johanna was head of the Turku Castle in Finland, the life of a stranger was more worthless than that of a burnt wooden penny. The peasants were given the right to hang all vagabonds and Romanies from the nearest gallows. But even for them, the last wish could not be denied. The peasant danced and danced on until the end of the world, for indeed, such was the magic of the violin. It was a wonderful instrument, even though it was well worn out. The oldest of the folk did not believe that it would last through any more snowstorms. One ought to ask for help from the new duke. The winter was drawing near, and there was no more bread to be found. Where would the children of the Romanies get their wings to fly to the castle? Johanna had problems of his own. He could not find a princess who would make a suitable bride. The wedding was to be celebrated with these matrons. Katarina Jagellonica from Krakow turned the Duke's head with her charm. The cold castle truly needed a wise and royal mistress, and the rich, spicy smells of a southern court. Soon, the invitation reached Poland, and late in the autumn, the royal marriage ship sailed for the north. In the land of the Finns, the guests were received badly. The ship became stuck in the ice. The wine barrels broke, and of the huge dowry, there remained only one trunk. The dancing bear murmured and muttered along with the musicians when the entourage saw the kind of castle that was awaiting them. The orchestra decided at once to sail back to Poland with the cembalo. But the honorable princess wanted to keep her promise. So, alone and unattended, Jagellonica stepped into the strange castle. Johanna thought that the princess looked much smaller than in her picture. Her servant wondered where had all the Polish treasures gone. In the trunk, they found only one mysterious object. The castle of Krakow was so far away. And the cold porridge only made her homesickness worse. When Johanna saw this, he asked his very best musicians into the hall. This only increased Jagiellonica's anger, and she announced that if there would be no better musicians in his empire than these, she would cancel the wedding. The Polish princess did not want to march to the altar to the rhythm of a birch bark horn. While wandering about in the woods, the sad duke sat down upon a rock just outside the camp of the Romanys. At that moment, Johanna forgot all about his wedding sorrows. These were the most wonderful musicians in all the surroundings of Turku. And, as well as to this very day, they also had a dancing bear with them. As for payment, the folk did not ask for any gold or silver, but only that the gallows be torn down all over Finland. And the violin, which was carved from these very gallows, still can tell us many strange and mysterious tales.